with Bobby Generic.
What's Generic?
The hope of the bobsled team as he attempts to capture the gold for the United States. Are you up to it, Bobby?
Not up to anything. I'm gonna bobsled.
You can do it, honey. Go for it.
Good thing I learned my colors. Red means stop, and green means go!
It's a new world record! It was so fast, we're going to rename the event the Bobby Sled!
That was a good one, Bobbo! Oh, you were flying down that slide!
Wow! It was great, Uncle Ted! Now it's your turn!
And I'm coming down like grease lightning! Watch me!
Oh. Fly down, Uncle Ted! You go faster that way!
Oh, yeah. That makes all the difference, yeah.
Uh-oh. I hope he doesn't go too fast, Roger.
That's a landing.
That was great! Come on, Uncle Ted, let's do it again!
Oh, I don't think so, Bobbo. My lunch platter from Bean Heaven's backing up on me. Beg pardon. Nothing to worry about, though.
Hi, Bobby. Wanna play dodgeball?
Great idea, Jackie! Me and Uncle Ted love dodgeball. Right, Uncle Ted?
Right on, Babo! Oh, got it!
I won!
Hey, anybody want to do shoulder flips?
Yeah.
Okay, who's next? Come on!
Your uncle is the best kind of adult there is, Bob. He's a big kid.
Yep, Uncle Ted's my bestest playmate.
Bobby, like it's totally time to Splitsville, okay?
Aw, Kelly, it's not time to go home yet, is it? Five more minutes.
Uncle Ted, you know I am not allowed to drive after dark.
Some people think you shouldn't be allowed to drive in the light.
Meet you back at the house, Bobbo. Hey, maybe we can squeeze in a game of ring toss before supper, huh?
Sure, Uncle Ted. You didn't use your turn signal, Kelly. Kelly, you're too close for that car!
Put a sock in it, Bobby! Like, I am the one with the license here, okay?
You better not be exceeding the speed limit or I'll tell Mom.
Do you totally want me to make you walk home?
No. I had fun with Uncle Ted today. All the kids think he's great because he likes to play so much.
Like, I think maybe that's because Uncle Ted is lonely, you know, and needs a family of his own.
He has a family! Us!
Not that kind of family. He needs a wife, you know, like someone to give him a purpose in his life.
A purpose?
You know, he needs, like, someone to make his heart sing.
He does?
I am singing!
Okay, I have been reading this totally down romance novel, Lorenzo's Loneliness. You know, and like Lorenzo, the hero, he is like completely nowhere until he falls in love and gets this incredibly radical wife.
Uncle Ted doesn't need a wife.
He does too.
Does not. He has me. Kelly, come here!
Bobby!
How come it's always so much honkier when Kelly's driving?
Boy, chopping onions always makes me cry like a baby.
Uncle Ted, ready to play ring toss?
As soon as I finish my snack here, Bobbo.
Roger, I think Uncle Ted was crying.
I think Uncle Ted's lonely. Lonely. Lonely.
Uncle Ted's not lonely. He has me to have fun with. Nobody's better at having fun than me and Uncle Ted. Right, Roger? Hey, Uncle Ted! Wanna play? You ready to quit, Uncle Ted?
ready when you are. Beg pardon.
How can I keep this up? I'm only one man. Maybe Uncle Ted does need a wife. What if Kelly's right? And Uncle Ted does need a wife? Where would he go to get one? Mom, Dad! We're gonna find a wife in a hurry!
Oh, isn't he the cutest?
Why do you need a wife, son? You got your mother here, at least for a few more years.
That's right, my little Mr. Manzie. You're not ready to be in the market for a wife just yet.
There's a market? Derek, do you know where the wife market is?
There's no such thing, dweeb.
And how do you get a wife?
Same way you get a car, nitwit. You look until you find one that's cool.
The same way you get a car?
Yeah, need a wife. Come on down to Crazy Sales. I've got blondes, brunettes, and redheads all in stock. Remember, Crazy Sales. That's the wingnut exit off the 310.
How would I know which one to pick? Maybe Kelly knows.
Go away. I'm like busy, okay?
But I need your help. Uncle Ted's been crying in the kitchen. And then we played and he wore me out. I was wrong. I'm not enough. Uncle Ted needs a wife.
Okay, you can come in. But don't touch anything.
Wow. This is the first time you ever let me into your room. This is very impressive.
Bobby, focus. If Uncle Ted doesn't find true love soon, he's gonna become like totally melancholy.
Melancholy? Will he have to get shots like Roger?
No, don't touch anything.
This is so cosmic. It's like this book was written about Uncle Ted. He's just like the hunk, Lorenzo, except that Uncle Ted is fat, loud, and a tacky dresser.
And I didn't think he was ever a soldier of fortune either.
No, but he was a clown at my birthday party once.
Focus. Okay, we have got to get serious about helping Uncle Ted. Okay, now Lorenzo met his true love, the exiled Princess Alana, when she was moonlighting as a dancer type instructor.
Wow, wings! I'm flying! I'm flying!
Put my thigh buster down this minute!
Bobby, okay, cut the comedy. Pay attention. We have got to save Uncle Ted from a lifetime of misery and woe.
Misery and woe? Who are they?
I know! We'll take Uncle Ted to my gym. There are all kinds of beautiful babes there for Uncle Ted to, fall in love with.
This will be so romantic. But we cannot tell anyone, or it'll ruin the surprise for Uncle Ted, okay?
Okay. Uncle Ted, guess what time it is?
Time for noogies.
No, it's time to go to Kelly's gym.
What am I gonna do there?
Dancer sides?
No, I think I'll just rest instead.
Did I mention that they're giving away free socks in a can to everyone that takes the class?
Hey, why didn't you say so, Bobbo? Let's get a move on.
You must be really lonely.
Just wait, Bobby. After this class, Uncle Ted will be a babe magnet.
A magnet?
Morning, class. Okay, let's get started. Here we go. And left foot first.
Left, Uncle Ted.
And right. Here we go. Now side to side, we're going into grapevine. Let's dance. Aha! Uh-huh.
You sure you like this?
Sure. Every kid loves the dancer size.
Now march with kicks. Here we go. Good job.
Okay, hold on. Slow down. I got it. Oh, slow down. Okay. Oh.
Uncle Ted was a magnet, all right. Right to the floor. Kelly, gotta hurry up and find Uncle Ted a wife, because it's starting to
get Welcome to Romance Hotline. This is your host, Romeo.
Romance Hotline! This is my very favorite show.
My hotline, it's open. Call me.
Oh my goodness, it's
all we have to do to find true love for Uncle Tad is call the Romance Heartline.
Hello, this is Romance Heartline. This is Rubio.
Hello? Rubio? My sister Kelly. She says that we need to find true love for my Uncle Tad so he won't have to spend the rest of his life with misery and, whoever they are.
Sure, little fella. Tell me your sad story.
Well, you see,
I don't want my Uncle Tad to turn into a melancholy.
The uncle is probably too old and stuff, but, you know, the kid sounds kind of cute.
And Uncle Tad gives the best nookies, and he's kind and eats trout on a stick.
Okay, Uncle Tad, huh? Yeah. Hey, Digger, when you remove my tattoo, leave the tea.
And mostly, I love him. And I don't want him to be sad. Well, I hope his true love is out there listening.
I'm so touched. I invite anyone who wants to meet Uncle Tad to send a letter to me. Rubio here at Romance Heartline.
Thanks, Rubio.
Ciao, okay?
No, thanks. I already ate.
Well, I'm so happy to meet you in person, Bobby. All the letters from women desperate to meet you, Uncle Tad, are in there. Good luck, little romance mongrels.
Wow! Look at all the letters!
Too old, too young, too much plastic surgery, too thin.
I like the dog.
Okay, dear Uncle Tad, my name is Rhonda, and my favorite thing is spending a rainy night in front of a fire.
I'd rather be in the fire truck.
Dear Uncle Tad, I'd love to spend hours taking long, endless walks on the beach with you, love, Binky.
Yuck, sounds boring. We'll never find Uncle Tad's true love.
Bobby! I think I have totally found her. Listen.
Dear Uncle Tad, I love trout on a stick, and I wear socks in a can, and I haven't had a good noogie in 10 years.
She's perfect! Rubio! We found her! Uncle Tad's true love!
Thank you, Bella Kelly, Miss Teddy Bear. My station will pay for a night of romance for Uncle Tad and his new love. After all, love is like a coconut. If she fall on your head, she can make you stupid. But if you crack her open, you can make a fabulous tropical drink and also a cake.
Is that good? Isn't it great, Roger? Kelly and me found a true love for Uncle Tad. Mom! When will Kelly get home?
Well, when she gets here, that's when. Why are you so jolly excited about your sister coming home?
No reason. I just like her.
Well, isn't that sweet there? Now, Kelly will be home before you know it.
Boy, moms know everything. What are you going to say to Uncle Ted's true love?
Chill, Bobby. Like, there is nobody who knows more about romance than yours truly.
Hello?
Hi. Miss Barrow? Yeah, I'm like Kelly, Uncle Ted's, secretary. And you, like, won the dream date with him, okay? Cool, huh?
I did. Great. How about tonight at 8?
No, I can't, he can't drive after dark. He can only drive after school.
Oh, is Uncle Ted a school teacher?
Huh? Oh, yeah, he's a professor. He's like a Howitzer Prize-winning professor.
Well, how about I meet him in an hour at Trout a la Everything? It's the best trout on a stick you can find.
Later. Perfect. Now all we have to do is get Uncle Tad to Trout a la Everything.
How hard could that be? Uncle Tad? Could Kelly borrow your car so she can drive me to get a Slurpee?
Kelly, drive my car? No, I'm up. Okay, I'll drive. Let's go.
Told you it would be easy to get Uncle Ted out of the house.
Seems like a pretty fancy place to get a Slurpee, Bobbo.
They have a new trout-flavored Slurpee I wanted to try. Excuse me, are you here to meet my Uncle Ted?
I don't even have to ask.
Kelly, Kelly, I found her!
Uncle Ted, welcome to your dream date from KLOV Radio.
Miss Teddy Bear, hello, former hula dancer from the Big Island of Hawaii. Pleased to meet ya.
Isn't this great, Uncle Ted? Now you can fall in love and be happy forever and ever and ever and have a wife and kids.
A wife? Kids?
Hey, man,
this is like so romantic.
Hey, hold it. Time out here, folks. What is all of this wedding talk?
Uh-oh. This sounds like trouble.
I mean, I wear socks in a can like everyone else, but I'm not ready for...
You mean you wear socks in a can? Me too!
Hey, I like that. But, you know, the thing is, I don't know if I'm ready to get married.
Me neither.
What about how lonely you are, Uncle Ted? I saw you crying in the kitchen.
I was cutting onions for my chili, Bobbo. I always cry when I cut onions.
Peel them and put them in the fridge first. Then you won't have that problem.
You don't say!
Well, if you're not lonely, Uncle Ted, then why were you moaning and groaning and acting so sad?
I've got really bad gas, Bobbo. It's killing me. Beg pardon.
I've been a little bloated myself today, so I ordered some chili peppers. Try one, it'll fix you right up.
Sorry. Oh, that feels good. Just what I needed.
Somebody ordered a sumo trout on a stick platter or what?
The sumo platter? You're my kind of woman, Miss Bear. Okay, let's eat.
Uncle Ted, are you for sure not in love with Miss Bear?
Well, I really like her, Bobbo, but in life it's important to know the difference between love and gas.
It is? Is it love or is it gas? That's the question you must ask when you're not sure and wondering if it's really love. Just take a whiff. Love is a feeling that makes you care. Gas is a feeling that fills the air. When you're in love, you love their hair. When they have gas, get out of there! Love is a feeling that warms your heart. Gas is a feeling that makes you one more time. Is it love or is it gas? This is the question you must ask. I'd sure rather be around when it's love in the air.
Hey, Bobbo, dig in. This is the best trout on a stick you ever tasted.
Trout!
Mom, where did you and Dad meet?
Well, let me see now there. I was the kielbasa queen at the state fair, and your dad had just won the kielbasa and bean chowdown. When I handed him his trophy, I saw that special look in his eyes, and I knew it was gee golly love.
But how'd you know for sure it was love? What if it was gas?
Well... The special look was still there after he gee-golly burped, don't you know?
I love you too, Mommy. Boy, that was some show.
Yeah, you know, it gave me a nice warm feeling inside.
Oh, really? Well, is it love or is it gas?
I won't tell you unless you pull my finger.
I don't think I want to know.